Today, we're getting real about what we don't do. T1D TV. So welcome back. You know, one thing I've been really trying to ask myself a lot lately is what could I be doing better? You know, I'm always preaching about get your quality of life up, make your experiences as high of quality as you can. But that comes with putting yourself in a state of quality care. You know, and I've been doing really great, but what could I be doing better? And after thinking about it, well,
just do it!
Yeah, that's right. Checking my blood sugar. It's always been my biggest issue with being a diabetic is having to test my sugar multiple times a day. It's half remembering, half fighting the diabetes burnout feeling of I don't want to. You know, and it's not to say that I don't know that I need to do it. I know that I need to do it. But honestly, there's nothing you can do but do it.
What are you waiting for? Do it!
Because if you don't do it, you're gonna feel like crap. I know if I don't check my sugar for a couple hours, I feel nauseous, I get a headache, I don't want to talk to anybody, I'm irritable. The point, I know when I check my sugar, I feel great, I feel energized, I feel social, I'm always hungry. Checking your sugar is one of the key factors to being as normal as possible. So why wouldn't you do it?
Do it! Do it!
Come on! Do it now!
My doctors have always told me that I need to be checking my blood sugar at least 4 times, if not 5 to 6 times a day. It's just the matter of doing it. And that goes along with anything in life, you know, when it comes to going to the gym. There's nothing to it but to do it. When it comes to cleaning your room, taking care of your finances, washing your car, or cutting your toenails. I don't friggin' know. But the point is, in everything in life, there is a feeling of, man, I just don't really want to do it. And there's truly nothing you can do but do it.
You can do it!
Oh, yes, we can. And yes, we will.
It's kind of like when my friends talk to me about fitness and wanting to lose weight, and some family members too. And they talk about how they all want to lose weight. You know, and when they talk to me about losing weight, they say things like, well, I want to lose this many pounds, but I need to buy this and this before I can do it. I need to get a gym membership, new shoes, a kettlebell, ab wheel. I need the perfect push-up from Walmart. All that stuff is great, and it does help, but there truly is nothing to it but to do it. You can do pull-ups almost anywhere, or some modified version of pull-ups anywhere. You can do all this stuff anywhere. Granted, when it comes to checking your sugar, you have to buy strips and you have to have a glucometer. That's a given. But there truly is nothing to it but to do it. You don't need an app to remind you. You don't need to set an alarm to remind you. You just need to be an adult, remember, and do it.
Don't let your dreams be dreams. Yesterday, you said tomorrow, so just do it!
Now, I'm kind of preaching to myself too, so don't feel like I'm being too harsh on you, because this comes right back to me, but it's truly the thought process that's kind of dawned on me over the past year or so with getting better with my quality of care. There's nothing to it but to do it, because to get to, you know, here's normal, here's type 1 diabetics, to get as close to here as possible, there's nothing to it but to do it. There's nothing you can do about it. And you don't want to stay over here, because staying over here feels like shit. Then you do everything you possibly can do to get as close as you can to here, normal. When I talk about normal, I'm not talking about you have to be a certain way, okay? The norm. Normality is what you make of it. Kind of is a battle of normality and originality. Originality is just, it's not having some kind of grand idea of what a person should be, but it's just being you and being a good person. But when I say normal for type 1 diabetic purposes, I mean normal within your range of what your blood sugar should be, right? So let's imagine you're on a graph. All right, here's the graph. You have normal range and you have your range. Now your normal range might be, well, let's use me for instance. 70-150 is like perfect, where my doctors want me to be. Now down here you have your numbers. The amount you check your sugar is gonna be the best measurement of your quality of care, how you're taking care of yourself, and it's ultimately gonna lead you to have better sugars. Let's say I only check my sugar 10 times in 1 week, right? That means in 1 week, business week, that means that in 5 days, I'm only checking my sugar 2 times a day, right? So I may range anywhere from 450 to 88, because I'm not really taking care of myself. If you're not checking it, you don't know what your sugar is, so you don't know how much insulin to do, exercise to do, water to drink, what to eat, yada, yada, yada. So those 10 sugars might be down here, up here, everywhere, right? But if I'm checking my sugar as much as I'm supposed to, a 5 day week, 5 times a day, 25 sugar checks. So my numbers down here is gonna go from this to something a little more like this. That's what I mean by norm, is judged off of where your sugars are within your normal range. Normal range is probably a bad thing. Let's change that. Target range. Your norm is going to be based off of your target range, because being within your target range is going to give you your optimal quality of care, quality of life, quality. It's going to give you quality. If you're only checking your sugar 10 times in a week, you're going to be all over the map. But if you're checking your sugar enough to keep a constant eye on your blood sugars and what your body is going through, then you're gonna have a higher quality of care, because you're gonna go from this to this. Why wouldn't you check it more? Everything in life is a big mental game. No matter what you do, you're always gonna have a feeling of uncertainty. Fear of failure is what I like to call it. You're always gonna feel like, man, I don't know if I can do this. I don't know if I can handle the struggle of having to do this. I don't know if I really wanna put up with stabbing myself in the finger 5 or 6 times today, because let's be honest, no matter how much we're gonna say, you get used to it after a while, that shit hurt. You're taking a needle and you're stabbing it into your fingertip. Hey, you ever got a cut on your fingertip? Imagine that happening every day, 5 to 6 times a day. It's brutal. It may be brutal, but it's a necessary evil. You know, it's all about your quality of life. It's not just about your quality of life. It's about the value of your life and what value you hold in the quality of your life. Is your life worth having to prick your fingers every day? Why wouldn't you check it more?
Just do it! Yes, you can! Just do it! If you're tired of starting over, stop giving up.